Hello, people of the internet. I am not an Englishman. I'm still making videos for YouTube. And in this particular one, I will talk about how to study filmmaking when you're not studying filmmaking. Basically, how to learn filmmaking without going to the filmmaking school. And yes, I am always dressed like this when I'm at home. Thank you for asking. First of all, just to clear it up, in this video I will not talk about whether you should or should not go to a film school. There's tons of other videos out on YouTube where they talk about this quite successfully. I personally have not gone to film school because it's slightly too expensive for my pocket. And so in the last couple of years I've tried to balance that out in studying filmmaking in my spare time, because I also have to work, as my landlords are very passionate of getting their rents, the same as my local store is very passionate about getting paid for the food. The first thing you should do is very obvious, and this and that is to watch films. Watch as many films as you can, watch good films, watch bad films. You will be amazed at how much more you can actually sometimes learn from watching a bad films. Because like the mistakes just stick out and you immediately know, okay, this is what I'm not gonna do, this is what I'm not gonna do. But one thing that might not be as obvious to some people is that you need to start watching films actively. So watch the films, and while you watch them, also analyze them. See what kind of shots they use, what kind of camera movements they use, what kind of sound there is, what kind of light, how they use the props, how they use the music. How the actors move, like there's this change in the scene and this actor went there, okay, so he overpowered or she overpowered him or her, whatever's going on. So, and the more you will do this, the more you will notice these things, and also the more you will know what things to be careful about, what to start noticing. And also, if you want to analyze a film properly, you will have to watch a film several times. Because the first time, if the film is good, you get sucked in by the story and by the acting and everything, and you really can't focus on details. So once you've watched it and you get the story out of the way, you can then sit down and say, okay, now I'll be just watching the camera, I will be watching the editing, how they went about this. There is a saying with which I completely agree, and it goes, if you haven't watched the film at least 5 times, you haven't really seen it. And when analyzing films, especially focus on the scenes you really loved, so the scenes that really captivated you, and then go analyzing them and see, okay, this is what they did there, and maybe try to get a script and read it, and okay, this is what happens here, the camera then moves here, this is the sound, I didn't even realize there's this sound coming from the back, and the music goes out, whatever. And you kind of will start to learn the mechanics, and in the long run this will also help you to build your own directing and filmmaking style. Which sounds kind of counterintuitive, because you're basically kind of copying other filmmakers, but you're not really. You're just copying the mechanics, you're learning the ropes, you're learning how the things work. Like if I want to achieve a certain effect, if I want to get to a certain emotions, this is what I can do to get there. These are the tools I can use to get there. So basically, watch and rewatch the films you like. One thing I would really encourage you not to do is read the reviews and ratings before you've seen the film, because the more you will learn about it and the more films you will review for yourself, the more you will learn that actually your opinion is more important than someone else's. And also, film is art, and reviewing any kind of art tends to be subjective. For instance, a 50-ish something guy from New York might like completely different things than a 30 something year old woman from, say, Eastern Europe. And you know, they grew up completely differently and they see things from different angles. But once you've created your own opinion, by all means do go and read reviews, because you will see that other angle of the film. You will see stuff that you haven't noticed and other people can, which will also build your knowledge on filmmaking. It's also important to keep, at least for me, to keep a journal on the films you've watched. There's a lot of apps out there if you're too lazy to write, although you shouldn't be. I personally use Todo Movies, I believe. They're not sponsoring or anything, I'm just using it. And it's really simple. Basically, you just check the films you've watched. They have an a database. I don't think I've ever seen a film that's not in their database. I don't know where they're pulling it from, but anyway. So just check the film you watched, and then you just, 1 out of 5 stars you rated, and this keeps, so it keeps track of how many films you've watched. But if you have an app that you're using and it's better than this, and it gives you other options, do please let me know in the comments. I'm always on the search for such a thing. I also have my own way of kind of reviewing, or rather writing notes on films. So once I watch the film, I created this document in Pages or Word or whatever you're using, and basically just put in the title and the details of the film, and then write a short synopsis, and then write the stuff that I really liked about the film, the things I really didn't like or I think didn't work, and then just go shortly write about cinematography, sound, music, editing, directing, screenwriting, acting. If there was a certain character that really stood out, and if there are like certain characteristics that I liked, and then maybe a quote that stayed with me, and a detail that really like stood out, which becomes a very good thing you can then lean on once you start making your own films. It's also easier when you're working with people and say, ah, in this film they did this, maybe we can learn something, and, you know, go. And when you're working with actors, you might give them an idea for a character, and so on and so forth. Basically, you create your own database of film. Try to go to the cinema as often as possible. This, I guess, will be much easier for people living in the cities that have more cinemas and more options. And also, if you can get an options of monthly subscription, it's also good, because it's like 20 quid or whatever, and it's all you can eat, basically. You can watch as many films as you want. And it's also good, in the cities I'm talking now, to have the cinemas which not only show the latest current films, which not only show the current films, but also older films and the classics and the stuff that's not in the cinema anymore, and also that have 35 and 70 mil projections, so you see the film as it was intended to be seen. Now, one thing that a film school offers and that homeschooling doesn't is networking, and I think this part is crucial to filmmaking. Like, this, you will not make a film unless you're surrounded yourself with people. Because when you're at film school, you're surrounded by like-minded people, you're surrounded by other students, and you kind of grow together, you learn about things, and you see which stuff you like. And basically, once you finish your film school, you already have your collaborators. You have your crew, maybe your cast, and they have their own connections, so, you know, by the time you get out of there, you have a massive network of people which will help you on whatever you go on working. Whereas if you're learning the skills of filmmaking alone, you don't have that privilege. But worry not, what can you do? So one thing you can and should do is go to film festivals. There's always film lovers and filmmakers, and go to Q&As, and then go to networking events and just have drinks and chat and meet people and network. This is how I started networking, and now I have quite a few people I'm working with. If this is not possible, maybe try some meetups or like some filmmaking groups in your local area. There's a lot of Facebook groups for filmmakers. If not, start your own group. You should always be proactive. And if you know there's any filmmakers in your local area, just try and contact them and get in touch, because you should talk about film, you should talk about filmmaking, you should share your experiences and your opinions. And sometimes it's just good to have someone that you can geek out on film completely, and they don't look at you like you're a complete idiot. Just feels good. Hi, just a quick note, I'm just editing this, as you can see at the back, and I've just realized it's way too long for a single video, so I'm gonna cut it here, and then I'm gonna post the video next week, so you either have to wait 1 week, or if you're from the future, then just click the link in the description and go to the part 2. Sorry about that, and thank you for being so cool and not complicated. Yay! And, you know, like, subscribe, all that stuff.